Well, I thank you, Lord, that you are my Savior. You're my strength and you're the rock on which I stand. You give me life and a grace that's greater. When I humble myself beneath your mighty hand, you bring times of refreshing. You bring times of refreshing. You bring times of refreshing to my soul. When I'm weary from the fight and trying to do what's right, you bring times of refreshing to my soul. When the day will come when we'll all be gathered, and the sun will rise with healing in its wings, and all the years of pain won't seem to matter. Behold our teacher and our king. You bring times of refreshing. You bring times of refreshing. You bring times of refreshing to my soul. When I'm weary from the fight and trying to do what's right, you bring times of refreshing to my soul. You bring times of refreshing. You bring times of refreshing. You bring times of refreshing to my soul. When I'm weary from the fight and trying to do what's right, you bring times of refreshing. You bring times of refreshing. You bring times of refreshing to my soul.
The Lord be with you. A couple of announcements. One is probably most of you don't know Kathy Zinter actually was a teacher.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-loving God, in your holy scriptures you tell us time and time again, fear not, do not be afraid. And by not being afraid, we know your kingdom. We can look at your creation without fear and know that we are one with you. Be with us this day and in the days and months ahead, that we always walk in your light, knowing there is nothing to fear. In the name of the most holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
We actually hear the good, the bad news all the time, because we all have this angst in life where we do not feel we measure up. We are sinners, and that's why God comes to us with the good news that for the sake of Jesus Christ, Almighty God forgives you and I all our sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our gospel lesson this morning comes from the Gospel of St. Luke, the 12th chapter. Jesus said, "Do not be afraid, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give alms. Make purses for yourselves that do not wear out, an unfailing treasure in heaven, where no thief comes near and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Be dressed for action and have your lamps lit. Be like those who are waiting for their master to return from the wedding banquet, so that they may open the door for him as soon as he comes and knocks. Blessed are those slaves whom the master finds alert when he comes. Truly I tell you, he will fasten his belt and have them sit down to eat, and he will come and serve them. If he comes during the middle of the night or near dawn and finds them so, blessed are those slaves. But know this, if the owner of the house had known at what hour the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an unexpected hour." The Gospel of the Lord. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share God's peace by greeting those around you. Heidi, peace. Olivia, peace. Yes, you may be seated. I'd like to invite the young people to come forward. Life in the Kingdom. That's what the sermon is about. Based on this verse and a fragment of the next one, do not be afraid, little flock, for it is the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Do not be afraid, or have no fear. Then sell your possessions and give alms. If you're citizens of the kingdom, you might not need all that other stuff, right? We'll talk about that. Martin Luther, in his theology, suggested that there are two kingdoms, and we are citizens of both. The kingdom of this world and the kingdom of Andrew Root from Luther Seminary. He is a theologian of culture. Isn't that an interesting title? Theologian of culture. But he was in Seattle. God became more real to you when you did not expect it. Is there ever a time when you felt God's presence when you did not expect it? And all of a sudden, Andy Root says, this woman became silent and still. And then she said, and through sacraments. Martin Luther understood God came to us through word and sacraments, and that's really the only thing we can trust in life. But God's kingdom can be seen, felt, realized through faith. Another example of this. I've been looking for examples all week long, and I've got all kinds of them. Did you know that the church in Iran is growing faster than any other church in the world? Then Jesus says to us, get rid of your possessions, give alms, give to the poor. Why? You see, when we're so caught up in the things of this world, it sometimes blurs our thinking, doesn't allow us to think about the kingdom of God. We want this world so much. So Jesus says, do yourself a favor. Divest a little bit. Invest in the kingdom of God. Every once in a blue moon, every 3 years maybe. But it's up to 500 million. I might as well take my stab at that, I guess. And you get in your car, and you have a few minutes of entertainment, which I figure is worth a dollar. You know, you think about all you could do with 500 million. Well, maybe if somebody else had the same number, 250 million, what I would do with it. And then, it doesn't take long. I start thinking, oh, well, it'll ruin my ministry. I'll have to give up being a pastor. And I'm sure Mick will divorce me. Has plenty of money. She doesn't matter who she's married to when she gets money. So all those things start coming into my mind, and it takes the fun away. Right? Well, we're so caught up with this worldly kingdom, and we forget, oh, but I'm living in another kingdom. God's kingdom. And it's God's kingdom that lasts. It's God's kingdom that is important. And it's the Father's good pleasure to give me that kingdom. So give. Give to the poor, the people that we might not care for, that need us. That's often because we learn something from them. Terry's going to show us a two-minute film about a guy that was a skinhead, Arno Michaelis. Arno, everybody remembers what a skinhead is. They were more popular in the 90s.
For 7 years in the late 80s and early 1990s, I was a member of white supremacist skinhead gangs. I was an organizer, I was a leader, and I was lead vocal in what we called a white power metal band. And of course, we hated anybody who wasn't white. We didn't consider Jews white, hated them.
I had a t-shirt printing company. We printed rock and roll t-shirts. His dad, he asked me if Arno could come to work, and I had so many people working there who were black, and Spanish, and Asian, and being Jewish was a very important part of my life. My Jewish faith had a lot to do with it because I was so open-minded.
I had black and Latino co-workers at Jack's. There was one incident where I was really hungover and I didn't have a lunch, and one of the black guys I was working with was sitting down and he's opening his lunch out and he's got like a sandwich cut in half, and he sees me there in the corner and he just kind of looks over there and he's like, "Hey skinhead, you want half the sandwich? You look kind of hungry." So here I am in my off time, I'm actually writing songs about how Jewish people take all of my money to give to lazy black people who don't want to work, when in actuality, I have a means of supporting myself thanks to the good graces of a Jewish man who didn't fire me for wearing swastikas into his factory, and black people actually feed me. Jack, like many other people, changed me by planting seeds of humanity that I really couldn't suppress despite my best efforts. The fact that he was a nice guy, and he gave me the benefit of the doubt, and he gave my buddies jobs, and really I had no reason to have any kind of grudge against him. The knowledge of that was something that always kind of ate away at me, and it hit me that if I didn't change my ways, death or prison would have taken me from my daughter.
I'm in this group, Serve to Unite, because it's very important to me to help make our world a more peaceful place and to help people get along together.
Serve to Unite was founded in response to the August 5th, 2012 Sikh temple shooting, where a white supremacist murdered six people. The idea was to transform this atrocity into an ongoing engine to bring people together and to truly defy the hate and violence behind the crime. My story is a pretty good example of sometimes how the biggest troublemakers can transform into the most powerful peacemakers.
That was put together by the First, you are God's beloved children, his flock, members of his flock. And that God, it's his pleasure to give us his kingdom. His pleasure. You're living in the kingdom of God as well as the kingdom of this world. And as we realize that, our purpose in life grows as we trust God's promises and give ourselves away in love. So remember, have no fear, little flock, for it is the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Amen. I'd like Zachary Hudson to come forward. Doesn't he look handsome in his uniform? Gracious God, holy and loving, let your church be dressed for action, enlightened and alert for your coming into the world. May we be open, and may we open the door to your presence and live even now within the joy of your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, creating God, the abundance of your creation fills us with awe and delight. Call us daily to be vigilant and responsible stewards of all you have made. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful God, calm the fears that produce wars, prejudice, and injustice. We pray for healing in our country, a healing of the racial discord in our country. Even as we celebrate the Olympic cooperation, we continue to pray for our world gripped by economic inequity, terrorism, and war. Equip governments, leaders, and peacemakers to be models of cooperation and reconciliation among the nations. Lord, in your mercy. Restoring God, comfort all who long for relief from circumstances of sickness. We remember especially Meredith Adams, Cindy Anderson, Lael Biella, Bryce Bauer, Carolyn Callan, Larry Carlson, Terry Carlson, Pam Cole, Dean Crane, Lucy and Lyle Dolly, Sandy Drake, Jeff Dykeman, Mark Henson, Alan Kamens, Carol Lohmeyer, Chris Marquardt, Annabelle Moore, Carolyn Knives, Sean Snellen, and Kathy Zinter and Dennis Chappelle. Are there any others? Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for your and give you thanks for all the saints who now enjoy unfailing treasure in heaven. Bless with your comforting presence all who mourn. Lord, in your mercy. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Holy God, our Maker, Redeemer, and Healer, in the harmonious world of your creation, the plants and animals, the seas and stars were whole and well in your praise. When sin had scarred the world, you sent your Son to heal our ills and to form us again into one. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The table is ready. Our Lord invites us. All are welcome. Please come.
This is the body, this is the blood, broken and poured out for all of us. And in this communion, we share in His love. This is the body.